There's something I'd like you to consider. In the first volume in this series of comments, I listed 176 reasons Donald Trump cannot and must not be elected President of the United States.
He has no real strategy for creating jobs, just a string of empty promises. Donald Trump offers no real solutions for the economic challenges we face. Here's the bottom line. Economists left, right, and center all agree Donald Trump will drive America back into recession.
Donald J. Trump, a real estate magnate and reality star with zero government or military experience, will soon be our 45th president. How did he pull this off? Why did so many pundits and pollsters fail to see it coming? And what happens next?
America is crying tonight. I'm not sure how much of America, but a very, very significant portion. And I mean literally crying.
Everybody is crying and so upset. And it is the end of their world.
Feels like the end of the world.
Is there a doomsday plan for a time like this?
Feels like we're trying to avoid the apocalypse.
This is Armageddon.
To other nations could lead to another world war.
President Trump could be setting the U.S. on a path to war. Do you believe that's true?
President Trump could put the nation on the path to World War III.
I think it was reckless. I think it was indefensible. It undermines America's standing in the world.
A lot at stake, potentially, for the planet.
Tonight, he is strengthening the forces of extremists in this region as no one has done before.
Plus the Supreme Court, who knows where that's going to go. So the only checks and balances we have are us, the View.
This is not going to work. It can't work.
You're awake, by the way.
But if you try sometimes, you might find you get
Richard, Dow is up 38% since the election. S&P is up 33%. NASDAQ's up 52.7%. Don't you wish you bought the futures back?
One final
Russell
thing.
Russell 2000, 41%.
As regards weakness,
Oh, we have a generational low for unemployment, 3.8%. An all-time low for African-American unemployment. That's historic. And of course, a stock market that's gone from Dow 18,000 to Dow 25,000 in a year and a half.
President Trump can truly solve this problem. That would be going down as a great president, and there's no way around that.
To say that President Trump ended the Korean War, I think it's going to be hard to get those words out of certain news people's mouths, but it's great.
But if you try sometimes, will you just laugh by? You get what you need.
See that news about jobs? More jobs available than people available to fill them. Never seen that before.
Our emissions right now are at 1992 levels. And it's not because of a treaty. It's not because of some piece of parchment signed in Paris or Kyoto. And by the way, we did it while keeping our energy prices half of those in Europe.
Wait, there's more. Median household income up $2,000 a year. Interest rates still low. Gas prices now retreating from $3 a gallon.
For you, I think this is a huge win. I compare it to winning the conference finals, and now it's on to the Super Bowl. I think you're absolutely right. This was a huge win, and President Trump has got something to put in the naysayers' face that basically says, trust me, I'm trying to get us to a level playing field. Donald Trump understands how to play this game.
President Trump became the first ruler to recognize Jerusalem as our capital. And today, the United States of America is opening its embassy right here in Jerusalem. Thank you. Thank you, President Trump, for having the courage to keep your promises.
If you think we'll be doing this well with Hillary Clinton as president and Nancy Pelosi as speaker, you are in Trump denial mode.